Live from Los Angeles, welcome back to Good Morning La La Land. I am so excited to welcome one of the world's top investigative psychics. She is the Persian medium, Fia Johansson. Thank you so much for being with us today.
Thank you for having me. Thank you so much.
Such an honor.
So what was your personal journey to solving some of the world's most unsolvable cases?
I started when I was at the age of 17, back in Europe, and basically, I figured about my abilities and what I'm doing and why I'm doing at the age of 7, which was kind of a scary.
Oh, yeah.
I figured that I can talk to dead people. They connected to me or they come through me. Then I felt that I can see things before they happen. Why I can feel and sense people constantly if something gonna happen to them. Why I can prevent things. So they take actually almost 4 years to understand about what can I do to help others? How can I help and use my abilities in order to make other people happy? I left my country and to Sweden, Stockholm. I was at the age of 14. Minus 30 degrees, not knowing any English, any Swedish, just my own language as Persian, completely by myself. It was hard, but I told myself, yeah. I said, Fia, this is your new journey. You have a gift. God gave it to you to help a lot of people around. And I'm so sure you will have something back if you just activate your gift, which I did.
Amazing. I mean, I think that for me, this is, I feel like the world needs to know this is normal. There's abilities that people turn on as they awaken. And so for me, it's not like you are some, like we all have gifts. But what do you say to people out there that may be dealing with some type of gift that they're freaking out about or they don't know what to do with? What advice would you give them?
We all have some sort of abilities and antennas that we can connect with universe and unknown, which we don't know about the answer yet, but there is unknown energies. There is something there that you can connect with. Some people, they believe in that. Some people, they feel and sense and they believe and things happen to them constantly. Some people, they don't believe because they want to be just logic. And if you be just logic, non-biologic important things happen.
True logic. Stuff anyway. We need both, right?
Yes.
Yes.
So logic and biologic, it has to be get a hand, like hand to hand together. What your question was is, everyone has some sort of abilities, but it depends on if you would love to activate it or not. Mm-hmm. And for some, I mean, I didn't understand why I can't do it, and I still don't. I still can't find any reason about it, but I do. I mean, one of the things that happened about a couple of years ago, one of my clients walked into my office, and he wanted to get advice about some investment. Out of sudden, I saw the female spirit around him, and I felt like, okay, what does that spirit want from me? What is exactly she is looking for when it comes to that gentleman directly when he walked into my office? Immediately, she connected to me and said, tell him that he has a teenage boy, 17 years, and he is in danger. I kind of felt like, what should I do? Should I ignore? No, I can't. I have to deliver the message. So I look at him and says, like, sorry if I interrupt you because we are talking about investment things, but do you have a teenage boy? He said, I don't have a teenage boy. I've never been married. And I said, well, then you do have a teenage boy. And he was like, come on, with all respect that I have, you know, Fia, I'm not going to believe in this. And guess what happened? She said, tell him, Rebecca, July 9.
Oh, wow.
And I immediately said, Rebecca, July 9. And he was like, what? That was my girlfriend 19 years ago, which she vanished after 6 months when we start to kind of dating. And I was like, okay, but Rebecca definitely not alive because dead people talking to me.
Wow.
You definitely has a child. You definitely has a teenage boy. He is in danger and you need to do anything and everything with ghosts to get there. So he said, I don't even know where they are. I don't even know where she is because I couldn't found her afterward. I said, she even mentioned where you have to go. And then I said, FL, Florida, and the rest, you have to figure it out. Find friends, private investigators, whatever. After 2 weeks of going back and forth, he found the teenage boy. 17 years and was really in danger, poor life, and not knowing what to do.
Wow. So how does that make you feel, to know that you had the
Spirit communicate with us all the time. They do have a power. They are not gone. So basically, if someone that you love, if something happened to that person, he or she always watching around, look into. So Rebecca wasn't really happy to go, you know, or even other side and go to heaven until to make sure that her son is in happy and nice place together with the dad.
Wow.
And I asked him, why Rebecca hide this baby boy? And he said, well, the reason was because I said, if you get pregnant, you have to do abortion. And that's why she ran away from me. So you see, after 17 years, he found the boy that he didn't even want it. But Rebecca forced him to be a dad, and he was so thankful and so grateful until now.
Wow. Fia, that's really incredible. Tell us a little bit about your book, Recoding Your Brain.
Yes, my book published 2016, and I do have a second book with Chicken Soup for Soul author, Jack and Phil, Success Strategy, and it's all about success, how to succeed, how to believe in yourself, how to connect with your own universe, which I always tell everybody, in order to connect with universe, you have to first connect with universe inside. If you don't know what you want, you can connect with the other side.
So well said. So incredible. Powerful. You're clearly very talented, and thank you for all your gifts that you're bringing, everything. So just as you go into wealth, how would you say for people to really connect with their wealth as well?
Wealth and prosperity and money is all energies, because we all made of energies, and money is flows, money is energies, and energies flows everywhere you go. If you ask, it will come. If you don't, it's not. That's what I always say to all my students, followers, and my fans. Your past was 2 hours ago, and your future, or 2 hours ago, and your future is about 2 hours from now. So you should not think that my past was crazy. I was this, I go through this and that, and my future is going to be very bad because I don't even know if I'm going to pay my rent. Because if you are not in the moment, if you are not manifesting in the moment, you are not able to get anywhere with prosperity, money, abundance, and material.
So right now, dear universe,
we're
open to receive.
You can ask and receive. And the first things that you should remember in order to recode your brain or unlock the kind of blockage that maybe you may have from the past, most importantly, is to believe in what you dream about. If you bully your own desires, if you feel that you are not deserved to be wealthy, if you're not feel good about like to be famous, it's not going to happen. So the first things start from universe inside of us in order to other people believe in us and our abilities.
Thank you so much,
Fia. Please tell everyone where they can find and follow you.
Persian Medium. Persian as a Persian, medium as a medium. I have Instagram, basically over 1,200,000 followers and 500,000 on my Facebook. Thank you so much for my followers and fans and everything. And thank you for having me. I really enjoy my time and beautiful energy here. God bless everybody. I send love, light, and blessing to each of you.
Absolutely.
Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Yeah, be sure to stay tuned. We have got Hallmark's cast of When Hope Calls, their original digital series. We're so excited to have them here with us on Good Morning LaLa. We'll be right back.